The MSI GS66 gaming laptop sells with DDR4-2666 memory despite the new Intel 10th gen platform supporting DDR4-2933. So let's find out what sort of a performance difference this actually makes in games and find out if it's worth upgrading to faster memory. By default, the DDR4-3200 memory that I'm using here runs at DDR4-2933 at CL21, while the DDR4-2666 ran at CL19. However, I was able to get my 2933 running at CL19.2 and match all the timings. So we should be in for a pretty fair comparison in terms of the memory speeds. Both configurations were two 16GB sticks in dual channel. You can tune the memory in the BIOS. Just press delete during boot up, then once in the BIOS, press right shift, right control, left alt and F2 to enable the advanced BIOS mode. From here, go to advanced settings, down to the overclocking performance menu, enable the overclocking feature, then go down to the memory overclocking menu down the bottom. Within here, you'll have all the memory options you could want. You don't have to tune the memory, but by default, most DDR4-3200 kits will run with slower timings than the 2666 sticks MSI are using. With that in mind, let's get into the gaming tests. Battlefield 5 was tested running through the same part of the game in campaign mode. I've got the stock DDR4-2666 results shown by the purple bars, and the faster 2933 results in the red bars. There was a small improvement seen to the average frame rates, however there was a much larger boost to the 1% low performance comparatively, though this was one of the better results out of the titles tested. Call of Duty Modern Warfare was also tested in campaign mode by running through the same section of the game. There was only a slight edge to the 2933 configuration this time, though at the end of the day, it's extremely negligible in this one. Shadow of the Tomb Raider was tested using the game's built-in benchmark tool, and this was one of the few games tested that actually saw slightly worse results with the faster memory. I'm not too sure why that was the case, but either way, the difference is only a few frames. PUBG was tested using the replay feature with the exact same replay file used in all instances. There was an above average increase to performance with the 2933 memory in this one. At max settings, the average FPS was 5% faster. However, check out the differences to the 1% lows. There's a massive 58% boost to 1% low performance at very low settings with the faster memory, though this was the highest change out of all games tested. Fortnite was also tested using the replay feature with the same replay file in all cases. There was a much smaller difference observed here comparatively, though there was still a slight edge to the 2933 configuration. CSGO was tested with the Uletical FPS benchmark, and there were minor differences at max settings. The 2933 config was just 1.3% faster in average FPS. However, with everything at minimum, it was now 7% faster. Dota 2 was tested playing in the middle lane, and was another game that despite seeing an increase in all instances with a faster memory, it was only subtle and nothing that impressive. Still better than a loss, I suppose. Speaking of a loss, Control was seeing lower average FPS at all setting levels with the faster memory. However, the margins were extremely minor. Margin of error stuff, realistically. I'd say it's performing about the same regardless of memory at all settings. Borderlands 3 was tested with the game's benchmark tool. The average FPS is basically the same with either memory option between high and max settings. However, the faster memory pulled out ahead between medium and very low. Although, even best case at minimum, the 2933 memory was just 4% faster in average FPS, and 6.5% higher for the 1% low. Overwatch was tested in the practice range, so performance is better than actual gameplay, but it allows me to more accurately perform the test run. Ideal for a comparison like this. Either way, basically no differences here. Far Cry New Dawn was tested with the game's benchmark tool, and there was an improvement seen at all setting levels with the faster memory, though not by too much. I've noted this game as being more CPU sensitive in the past, and memory is definitely tied into that. The Witcher 3 also saw some improvements with the faster memory. However, once more, like most of the other games tested, it wasn't that much and wouldn't realistically offer a perceivable difference in most cases. Assassin's Creed Odyssey was tested with the game's benchmark, and the performance varied based on the setting level, but again, not that much difference regardless of the setting level. Some saw a slight increase, while others were down. Rainbow Six Siege was also tested with the game's benchmark tool, and although the average FPS was ahead slightly for the most part with the faster memory, interestingly, the 1% lows were down at all setting levels. I'm not too sure what the deal was here. Ghost Recon Breakpoint was tested with its benchmark tool as well. Average FPS was quite similar with a larger boost seen with the faster memory at max settings, though it was still only a 2 FPS change. These are the differences to average FPS over all 15 games tested with the highest setting preset. On average, the DDR4-2933 configuration was just 1.2% faster than the DDR4-2666 configuration that the GS66 ships with. So not that big of a difference. There were some titles that basically saw no change, or even slightly worse performance, though 1% is pretty negligible and probably margin of error range anyway. When we look at the differences to average FPS at the lowest setting levels, there's a slightly larger 1.5% improvement to average FPS with the DDR4-2933 configuration. Presumably, the memory matters more as we're more CPU bound. And some competitive games like PUBG and CSGO saw a fairly respectable 7% performance improvement. There are much larger swings when we look at the 1% low performance at minimum settings. There's the strange Rainbow Six Siege result down the bottom. Not sure what the deal is there, but it's the only game I tested with Vulkan. Meanwhile, PUBG and Battlefield 5 saw huge boosts to the 1% lows with the faster memory. So 2933 should offer a much more stable experience there. I'm testing the GS66 with the Intel iGPU disabled. It might be possible that the higher memory speeds are more beneficial when the Intel graphics is enabled. However, I haven't tested that here, as this video was meant to be specific to the GS66. And it's my honest opinion that most people playing games will be using it in discrete mode. Outside of gaming, I've also run the A64 memory benchmark, and the DDR4-2933 configuration was hitting 9% faster read speeds here, so a far higher result than what we saw in the games. But this would be because the bulk of the games aren't constrained by the memory bandwidth. So in some games, the memory change can make a huge difference. But once we average multiple titles together, on average, it's nothing that impressive. Unless you're playing a game that sees a good boost with DDR4-2933, it's probably not worth replacing the 2666 sticks that ship with the GS66 with faster ones. At the same time though, the GS66 seems to be positioned as a more premium gaming laptop, so it seems a little strange to me that they didn't just use the best possible memory configuration for it. Maybe they just have a ton of 2666 sticks they need to use up or something. I'd be interested to hear your thoughts on the performance differences, and whether or not MSI should have just given the GS66 faster memory out of the box. Let me know down in the comments, and if you're new to the channel, then get subscribed for future laptop comparisons and tech videos like this one.